So, good day. This is Jessa Castile. It's IT3A. Today's video, I'm going to do the activity 7.1.5. Verify non-convergence using commands. So task 1, verifying existing connectivity. Step 1, ping from router 2. Access router 2 and from the CLI, issue the following commands. So first, click the router 2. Then go to the command line interface. And verify links that status mention the command show IP interface brief. So this is the output of the interface brief. And then ping the 172.30.1.1. So the ping will be partially successful. So let's ping. So the success rate is 40%. And then ping the 172.30.1.1. The ping will be partially successful. So the success rate is 40%. And next, step 2, ping from router 1. Access router 1 and from the CLI, issue the command. Issue the following commands. So next is the R1. Then go to the command line interface and ping the 10.1.0.1. So the ping will be successful. Copy. So the success rate is 100%, 5 over 5. And then ping the 172.30.100.1. So the ping will fail. So the success rate is 0%. 0 over 5. It's failed. And next is the step 3. In step 3, ping from router 3. Access router 3 and from the CLI tab, issue the following commands. So I'm gonna click the R3. Then go to the command line interface. And ping 10.1.0.1. So the ping will be successful. So the success rate is 100%, 5 over 5, and next ping visibility 2.30.1.1. So the ping will fail. Success rate is 0%, 0 over 5. And then in task two, summoning the routing table. Step one, summoning the routing table on router two. Access router two on top of this LI, examine the IP routing table by showing the command show IP route. So I'm gonna click again the router two and then copy the show IP route. Notice the two equal code paths to network. Reservable +16. Alternate packets intended for that network are sent to the wrong way. And then step two, examine routing table on R1. Let's click the R1. And then access router R1 and from the same item show IP route. So this is the output of the IP route. And then step three, examine the routing update sent and received on R2. Access router two. So let's click the router two. And then access router two when it's all covered. Enter Google's exit menu view routing updates issuing the command debug IP read. Debug IP protocol debugging is on. Okay. And then issue the command and debug all to turn off debugging. So all possible debugging has been turned off. So let's close. And then view the problems and solution. Step one, simulate to trace the things. Enter simulation mode. So simulation mode. And then the event list folders is set to show only ICMP events. So it's only ICMP. And then access router 2. From the CLI, issue the command ping. So I'm gonna click the router 2. And issue the command ping. And then click the auto capture play button. Watch the simulation. So I'm gonna click the capture forward auto capture play button. And then click the colored box in the info column in the event list for all the events. Examine the video information up layer 2 to understand what happened during the ping. So I'm gonna put the colored box. So in layer 3, IP header source IP 209.265.200.233. Destination is the IP 172.30.1.1. ICMP message type A, B, or A, B. So the ping process starts the next ping request. The ping process creates an ICMP Picker request message and sends it to the lower process. The router encapsulates the data into the IP pocket. The router looks up the destination IP address in the routing table. The routing table finds a routing entry to the destination IP address. The destination network can be reached via 109.165.200.234. So the serial 0/0/1 receives the frame. Layer 3 IP header source IP 209.165.200.234, destination IP 209.165.200.233, IP message type 3, IP header source IP 209.165.200.233, destination IP 172.30.1.1, ICMP message type B. So the device sends back on ICMP host under trouble message. The router looks up the destination IP address in the routing table. The routing table finds a routing entry to the destination IP address. The destination network is directly connected. The router sets destination as the next hub. So the serial 001 receives the frame. And then reset the simulation and repeat the process for the other. Reset the simulation. So reset. And then change the event list filters to show only RIP events. So let's change it to RIP. RIP. And then click the auto capture play button. Auto capture. And then click the color that's in the info column in the event list for all the event lists. Examine the video information at layer 3, layer 4, and 7 to understand the exchange process. And also examine the inbound and outbound video details to understand the content of DAW or IP of bits. So let's quick DAW color box. So in layer 3, the IP header source IP is 205.165.200.229. The destination IP 255.255.255.255. And layer 4, UDP source port 520, and DSD port 520. And in layer 7, the RFP version is 1 and the command is 2. So in outbound, so this is the content of the RIP. So that's all. Activity is completed.